Hey guys, this is Angga Rizky and welcome back to the video tutorial about Framer. Alright, in the last video we have to learn about how to make the beautiful UI design and how to use the rectangle and how to use the text and how to get the icons based on material design from the Framer directly. Well, in this video I want to show you about the group, but in the Framer we call it parent. It's not group, but it's parent. Okay, so we're gonna to learn more about the parent layout and about the simple code like the user like the layer targeting. Alright, well, we go to Framer. Oh, I click this. It's canned, so we just need to click here. Okay, this is the layer. We have three layer. 1, 2, 3. But when we move like this, it's only one layer. Okay, understand? But when I'm trying to move here and I move here, it's two layer. So it's called the parent layer. It's I can't make the group, but we can make it parent layer. Just click the layer and move below of the parent, and there we go, like this. But if you are move the layer above the parent, so when you are move the parent, the layer outside the parent. Okay, cool. So now we are talking about the user targets. Okay, want to click this. I want to remove first. Okay, so we just need to remove every layer. Every layer has the event, animation and statement. So when we hover the layer, you can see the small bullet points for create the target. What this for? Basically, these bullets help us to make the layer inside of the code section. Okay, so we can click here because we don't make the layer to enable to the codes. So well, just go to rectangle. Maybe we can start from the hamburger menu. Just click here and give the layer name, maybe the menu bar. Okay, and enter and go back to the code section, and you will see we have the menu bar. Okay, it's called the layer targeting. Before you want to make the animation in the Framer, you need to make the user layer targeting first. So I click here and this is the header title, and when I click here, it's called the BG bar, background bar. Alright, well, we'll go back to the code, and we have so many item here. And then I wanted to give you the simple animation from this Framer. So when I click this menu bar, it's going to the animation for the BG bar and for the header title. So we're gonna to click the menu bar layer and add event. Click and click menu bar dot on click. When the click, it's like the JavaScript or jQuery. Maybe you are familiar with the JavaScript language, so you will understand what this mean. When the layer menu bar on click, we have the parameter, or we have the event and layer, and directly to BG bar layer and animates. Okay, sorry, we don't have this. Okay, animates, and then just enter and tap. When we tap, we want to make this BG bar has the property, maybe the height is okay. So when I click here, it's going like this. Pretty cool, right? Okay, And I want to change the background color, maybe to the blue. Cool. Okay. And change. And I want to add another layer, maybe the header title. Animate and enter. And the opacity is 0.3. Why it doesn't working? Because we are forget to press the tab. So when we click here, it's working. Okay, so be careful when you are coding about the framer. You need to tap, 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 and tap. Alright? And I want to make the menu bar has the animation about the maybe the rotation going to 90 and the time. Sorry. And the scale maybe to the big, maybe 2. So when I click here, wow, it's pretty cool. It's a framer. Beautiful. Maybe I want to change to like this. Shoot. Yeah, I love this framer. It's easy to use, but you need to understand little bit of codes. So don't worry, we can learn together. That's why I make the video, so we can learn together. And the question is, why this header title is going to middle? Because we make this is inside of the parent, so we can move like this and go back to codes and click again. Okay, so it's not going to middle. Pretty cool, right? Yeah, I love it. Yeah, but unfortunately, when we want to refresh again, just click right and reload, and like this and reload. Oh, what's that? We can inspect element. Oh, it's cool. It's good for the developer. So we can inspect element for each the elements, and we will get the source code that we can use in the project. Alright, so thank you very much for watching this video, and let me know if you have any questions so we can discuss together. Don't forget to subscribe Angga Rizky in YouTube. See you!